In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning.
As we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sin. I confess
to Christ the Lord,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my extreme fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who governeth all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people, and bestow your peace upon them. Through Christ our Lord. Thank you.
high priest had been taken out of mankind and was appointed to act for men in their relations with God, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. And so he can sympathize with those who are ignorant or uncertain, because he too lives in the limitations of weakness. That is why he has to make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor on himself, but each one is called by God, as Aaron was. Nor did Christ give himself the glory of becoming high priest, but he had it from the one who said to him, "You are my son. Today I have become your father." And in another text, "You are a priest of the order of Melchizedek, and forever." During his life on earth, he offered up prayer and entreaty, aloud and in silent tears, to the one who had the power to save him out of death. And he submitted so humbly that his prayer was heard. Although he was son, he learned to obey through suffering. But having been made perfect, he became for all who obey him the source of eternal salvation, and was acclaimed by God with the title of high priest of the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
Keep by his faith, O God.
You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old.
You are a priest forever,
a priest like Melchizedek of old. The Lord's revelation to my master, "Sit on my right, I will put your foes beneath your feet." You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old. The Lord will send from Zion your scepter of power. Rule in the midst of all your foes. You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old. A prince from the day of your birth, on the holy mountains, from the womb before the daybreak, I begot you. You are a priest forever, a priest like Melchizedek of old. The Lord has sworn an oath he will not change. You are a priest forever, priest like Melchizedek of old.
You are a priest forever,
a priest like Melchizedek of old. Alleluia, alleluia. Accept God's message for what it really is, God's message, and not some human thinking. Alleluia.
In the way in which he will do this. Hence, the conversation that we hear in this morning's gospel, especially our reference to new wine, fresh skins. This new teaching, this new way, will become the foundation of the church. Let us always remember that we too are called to renew ourselves in hearts, minds, and bodies. So let us turn to the Lord in our prayers and thank this day. We pray for the church and all God's holy people, that they may always know that they are called to renewal and new life. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for our world and its many needs. We pray especially for those who try to broker peace where there is war, those who try to bring justice where there is injustice, that they may be given the strength to persevere in their position. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for those who find it difficult to come to terms with change in the midst of their lives. We pray that they will be given courage to renew themselves in light and in faith. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for those who are sick that their health may be refreshed and renewed, that they may be given the support that they need. Lord, in your mercy, those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur this time, that they may be welcomed into the kingdom of heaven. Lord, in your mercy, we ask for the prayers of love and worship as we pray to you. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We may please with all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become us spiritual
drink.
Give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is true, right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through him made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will again for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we adore.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Make holiness these gifts new by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you will eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink that. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have had his word to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Saviour's command and the form of thy divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive
forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our lives, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord. Let us pray.
Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ.